I think there are two different sorts of challenges for teachers when they are teaching problem solving. So there are mathematical challenges and there are pedagogical challenges, challenges about the teaching. So for mathematical challenges, teachers have to be able to see the potential richness of a problem, to see what it would teach well, to see how the students in their class are likely to solve it, how they're going to think about it, to see how they can help students, whatever ideas the students have, to think about how they can solve it. So mathematically, there are quite a few different challenges for teaching problem solving. Teachers also have to be thinking on their feet, not just prepared talk. Now, the pedagogical challenges are also very interesting. The main job is to make sure that they keep the focus on the higher order types of thinking. So, for example, to make sure that students really do think through the problems themselves, to be able to work in groups, but to work in groups on the problem and to think deeply about the problem. So there is a lot of research that shows, particularly when teachers begin to teach problem solving, they slip down instead of achieving the higher goals because of the practical classroom things. It doesn't achieve that. So that's one of the things that teachers have to learn to do, how to focus on the deeper mathematical thinking. Yes.
Y la segunda cuestión es que, bueno, últimamente estamos escuchando sobre el método de Singapur, los lesson study, como modelos de enseñanza de la matemática que se hacen a través de la resolución de problemas. Quería preguntar sobre qué diferencias y qué semejanzas podríamos indicarnos sobre estos métodos y qué recomendaría pues, a futuros docentes que estudiasen acerca de la resolución de problemas.
Okay, so Singapore and lesson study are quite different. Singapore is quite a small country and they decided in about 1990, so nearly 30 years ago, to put problem solving at the centre of their curriculum. They knew it would take a long time and they have been working persistently to do this. Because there is a national effort and an understanding that it will take time to achieve, but they can see improvements in their students' problem solving. One of the other nice, very good things about Singapore, I think everybody can copy, is that students in Singapore have three home languages, Chinese, Indian, and Malay, but school is in English. So right from the start, the Singapore educators tried to find visual methods to help students see problems. So they have some very strong methods. So for example, for ratio proportion, they have a double number line. For example, meters, hours. So a dual number line, but a visual method so that all the students can understand. And for word problems, they have a way of drawing out the relationships in bars and seeing the connection, their bar model method. So as well as having a commitment to problem solving, they have these visual methods. And I think the other thing to be impressed about is that they try to make sure that all students can do quite complex problems, much more complex, for example, in Australia. Now, the lesson study, quite different, Japan and China. Lesson study is a way of teachers working together to improve lessons. Now, this is why it is popular, why it is important. It's very practical. Teachers in the school work together and they plan a lesson, they research the lesson, they identify the difficult teaching point, and then one teacher will teach the lesson, others will watch it and critique, and gradually the school builds up a wonderful collection of lessons. So they call their lessons polished stone. Do you know, instead of just a rough stone, polished to make a beautiful thing, and that is done through a process of lesson study. So it is meant to be professional development for teachers, but really focused on watching the students learn. So that's a very good thing for everybody to know.